What is going on, guys, and welcome back to another video, and this is going to be the final episode of the top 10 rounds. I know you guys have enjoyed the series, but since the footy season is going to commence next week, I thought, well, I've got to switch up my content, and the top 10 rounds was really only to cover the lack of footy content. So thank you guys for watching this series, and comment down below what your favorite game is. But we've still got the last episode, and apologies for being late. Had an English stack to work on, but it's going to be the top 10 round 12 games in the AFL since 2000. So at number 10 on our list, we have the Adelaide versus Hawthorn clash in 2008. After the Crows got the first three scoring shots, the game remained neck and neck, with the highest lead getting out to 13 points midway through the third. Michael Osborne and Luke Hodge kicked the last two goals with 5 minutes remaining, which proved to be crucial as the Hawks went on to win by a mere 4 points. Now at number 9, we have a Friday night ball burster between Adelaide and St Kilda in 2012. In a high scoring affair, the Crows enjoyed a 31 point lead at 3 quarter time. Taylor Walker then had numerous chances to put the nail in the coffin early in the last. With close to 6 minutes left, the Crows looked home as they were up by 27 points, but then the Saints went an absolute rampage, kicking the next 4 goals, bringing it to within a kick. However, the Siren beat the Saints as the Crows went on to win by 4 points. Straight in front, brings St Kilda
within a kick after the Siren. Remarkable. Full-time, Adelaide 17-13, 115. St Kilda 16-15, 111.
At number 8, we have a classic between Hawthorn and the Blues in 2001. The Hawks were well on top early on, kicking 7-2 in the first and taking it to a 29-point lead at half-time. The Roos were gradually able to reduce the lead, but with 5 minutes left, were still down by 21 points. Soon after that, the Roos scored the next 3 goals in quick succession, but just like number 9 spot, the Siren beat them as they fell short by just 3 points. Now coming in at number 7, we have a more recent affair between the Blues and the Giants in 2017. Coming into the game, 2nd place Giants were taking on 16th place Blues in what appeared to be an absolute whitewash. However, the Blues managed to take it up to the Giants and were the dominant team for the first 3 quarters in a tight, low-scoring battle. Countless GWS errors and behind managed to bring them back the lead. And he drills it. And Zach Fisher managed to kick the match-winning score to win Carlton the game by only 8 points.
Goal would have been handy. Vic, every Blue back in defence, slammed out. The Blues fans, no! They have done what every other team hasn't been able to do this year. Beat the Giants in a close one. 1 second left. The siren sounds. It doesn't get any better than that.
Now in number 6 place, we have the Port Adelaide versus Bulldogs thrilling encounter in 2016. In a highly anticipated game, the Power needed to beat top 8 Dogs to be in contention for the top 8. In an electrifying start, both teams managed to pile on goals whilst it still remaining close all game. The Power kicked the last 3 goals of the 3rd quarter to steal back the lead. He's woken up! But then the Dogs kicked the first 3 goals of the last in quick succession to regain the lead.
Loads up and launches. Not touched. That is scary good.
That proved to be enough as the Dogs went on to win the match by just 3 points.
Catch that.
Need. Through hands. Seconds keep rolling. 4, 3, 2. Dogs win an epic. Dogs win an epic for their first ever win at the Adelaide Oval.
Now in 5th place, we have a high scoring encounter between the Blues and the Power in 2015. After getting out to a 23-point lead, the Power quickly reduced the margin to less than a goal at halftime. However, the Blues then got out to a 29-point lead early in the last. The Power were able to come back and managed to kick 5 of the next 6 goals of the game, but just fell short by 4 points. At number 4, we have a 2003 thriller between the Tigers and the Blues. In a tight encounter, the Blues kicked the last 4 goals of the third as they recorded a 13-point lead in the final break. In the last quarter, the Tigers kept coming at the Blues as the margin got out to only a point. However, the Blues managed to hang on and win by 7 points thanks to a 5-goal haul to Justin Murphy.
The Blues win! Carlton snapped their losing streak. Despair for Danny Freud. And the game ends in the hands of, Ryan Houlihan.
In number 3, we have a nail-biter between Carlton and West Coast in 2002. The Blues were looking for only their second win of the season, whilst the Eagles were pushing for a top 4 spot at Optus Oval. The Eagles brought it out to a 24-point lead early in the second before the Blues were able to quickly bring it back to their terms. With only 7 minutes to go, the Blues enjoyed a 13-point lead before Peter Matera and Adam Hunter kicked 2 quick goals to level the scores.
Peter Matera, a couple of goals, and now all of a sudden, the margin within 1 kick.
Mark Miranda then kicked the winning point for the Eagles as they went on to win the game by just 1 point.
And look at the anguish on the faces there of the Blues supporters. Hold on, West Coast are going to win by a point. 1 second remaining, West Coast to win their first game in Melbourne via a decision on the boundary line. There it is, the Eagles, 7-5, have defeated Carlton in another comeback, 2-2 weeks for the West Coast Eagles. Nothing going right for Carlton.
Now at number 2, we have a 2010 Queen's Birthday thriller between Melbourne and Collingwood. The D's then kicked 6 of the next 7 goals to only be down by 1 at half time. An inaccurate Collingwood outfit kicked 1-9 to keep the Demons in the game. With not long left, Matthew Bate put the D's in front for the first time of the match. Before Tarkin Lockyer kicked a goal as the game ended up in a draw.
76 plays 76.
Unfortunately, he did. Great contest. Morton goes and goes again, and the siren sounds. An anticlimactic finish to a sensational game. And at the end of it, it's a draw. 11-10 76 to 9-22 76.
In first place, we have a high-scoring Friday night classic between the Cats and the Blues in 2014. After Carlton gaining an early edge, Geelong kicked 7 goals in the second quarter to gain a 19-point advantage at halftime.
Tom Hawkins puts him in front of McColeman if he gets it, and gives Geelong, more importantly, a good lead at halftime. He's got it. So Hawkins with 4 goals in one quarter.
But then in another lead change, the Blues were able to regain the lead, placing Geelong on the back foot. Joel Selwood won a clearance and kicked the match-winning goal to win them the game by just 5 points.
And the kick is good! Geelong in front.
Can't quite get out. Still not out. Still not out. Umpire just letting it go. Won't blow the whistle.
Oh, trapped.
And I reckon... Yep, I reckon the siren is about to sound and Geelong have escaped. What a night. The Cats win.
and probably bury the Blues.
So there we go. Those were the top 10 round 12 games in the AFL since 2000. Unfortunately, in the last top 10 rounds video, the games weren't really as good as we saw in the other games, and the Blues managed to get 5 top 10 features. Make sure to leave suggestions for any video ideas down below, as I will no longer be doing these top 10 round videos since the footy season is coming back next week. I'll also be bringing back the Footy News series with Mitch Ryan approximately around 1 or 2 times a month, so definitely stay tuned for that, and stay tuned for more awesome content coming out very soon. Subscribe for more of this awesome AFL content, and I'll see you guys very soon in my next video.